In 1946, the Royal House of Savoy was Europe's longest reigning dynasty. The family's sovereignty dates back about 1,000 years. Its lineage extends through an unbroken succession of more than 40 counts, dukes, and kings, whose ancestral rule began in the area where today France, Italy, and Switzerland come together, in the vicinity of Lake Geneva, and then gradually expanded over the Savoy dynasty's 1,000-year history to include the unification of the entire Italian peninsula, Sardinia, and Sicily into the modern Italian state. This millennium of the Savoy royal family's history began with the first reigning member of the Savoy family, Umberto I, known as the White-Handed, who was born about the year 972. As the first Count of Savoy, he was granted his lands by the Holy Roman Emperor Conrad II. Starting from these lands, later generations of Savoys would further establish their rule, eventually consolidating their power through diplomatic relationships and dynastic links with the royal courts of France, Spain, England, Germany, and the Byzantine and Austro-Hungarian empires, as well as the city-state regions of Italy. They eventually became kings when, at the end of the War of the Spanish Succession, Victor Amadeus II of Savoy became King of Sicily in 1713, and a few years later, King of Sardinia Piedmont. Through their building programs, the Savoy sovereigns created cosmopolitan courts that thrived as artistic and cultural centers. By the 1860s, the heads of the ruling dynasties of the two Sicilies, France, Austria, Tuscany, Modena, and Parma, and even the Papal States in central Italy, would yield their Italian hegemony to the rule of the House of Savoy. These regions of what now comprise modern-day Italy were almost completely unified between 1861 and 1871 under the Savoy's aegis and the leadership of King Victor Emmanuel II. He was followed by King Umberto I, King Victor Emmanuel III, and King Umberto II. However, eventually in 1946, the Kingdom of Italy ended following a closely contested plebiscite which established the Republic of Italy. King Umberto II, the last king of Italy, never abdicated the throne and during his exile continued the traditions of the Savoy orders until his death in 1983. He was succeeded by his son, His Royal Highness Prince Victor Emmanuel of Savoy, who became then and remains today head of the Royal House of Savoy and Grand Master of its dynastic and hereditary orders of knighthood and merit. As Duke of Savoy, Prince of Naples, and hereditary Grand Master of the Supreme Order of the Most Holy Annunciation and the Order of Saints Maurice and Lazarus, the Prince also confers merit orders of the Royal House, the Civil Order of Savoy for civil merit, and the Order of Merit of Savoy. By conferring the family's dynastic and hereditary honors, Prince Victor Emmanuel continues a millennial family tradition of rewarding individuals for their achievements and service, a tradition which began with his forebearer, Count Umberto I of Savoy, about the year 1003. Today, the knights and dames of the Savoy orders are represented by over 40 national and regional delegations throughout the world. Worldwide administration of the orders is directed by the Prince as Grand Master and by the Grand Chancellor from their headquarters offices at the Chancellery in Geneva, Switzerland. Their goals are the eternal goals of the Savoy orders: to foster the spirit of chivalry by making a deep personal commitment to humanitarian ideals, by financial support and dedication to charitable and benevolent work. The Savoy orders have a strong and growing presence in the Americas. Headquartered in New York City, the American Delegation of Savoy Orders and its charitable arm, the American Foundation of Savoy Orders, a 501c3 tax-exempt charitable organization, support the charitable, cultural, and dynastic traditions of the orders in North America. Many of these international charitable activities are also directly supported by the worldwide membership of the Savoy Orders through the International Association of Knights and Dames of the Savoy Orders in Switzerland. To coordinate the charitable, cultural, and dynastic traditions of the Savoy Orders in North America, the American Delegation of Savoy Orders is administered by a delegate who is appointed by the Grand Master, His Royal Highness Prince Victor Emmanuel of Savoy. The American Delegation supports the Order's charitable work. It also sponsors social activities, anniversary observances, and commemorative religious services for significant occasions. By special arrangements, new members and promotions who are unable to attend the annual installation and promotion ceremonies in Europe may be presented their honors in North America in a ceremony sometimes held in the Cathedral of St. Patrick in New York City. Each year, the international traditional ceremonies and events of the Savoy Orders are held in Europe. They are highlighted by a chapter general, which is called Capitolo Generale. Led by the American delegate, candidates, members, and friends of the American delegation of Savoy Orders attend the annual Capitolo Generale and convocation, usually held in Geneva, Switzerland. The Capitolo Generale commences with an installation ceremony presided over by the Grand Master, His Royal Highness Prince Victor Emmanuel of Savoy, and the Grand Chancellor. During this event, the Prince as Grand Master presents diplomas and insignias to new members, while also promoting deserving members of the Savoy Orders whose dedication and devotion to the Orders merit special recognition. The chapter's events include a formal benefit gala ball, which raises funds for the international charitable works of the Savoy Orders. On Sunday, a solemn mass is celebrated with a procession of knights and dames in their church robes. These masses take place either at the historic abbey of Saint-Maurice d'Augon in Switzerland, built on the site of the martyrdom of Saint-Maurice, or at the royal abbey of Hautecombe, located in the old duchy of Savoy, burial site of many of the dynasty's members. A farewell benefit luncheon usually follows the mass. Members of the American delegation of Savoy Orders and their guests conclude the Capitolo weekend of events with a tour of Savoy-related historic sites in nearby Switzerland, France, or Italy. The administration of the Savoy Orders and their charitable work in North America is the responsibility of the American delegate, supervised by an international coordinator and assisted by his vice delegates and a national council. The council meets twice each year to discuss administration and expansion of the Savoy Orders in North America. These meetings cover reports from the vice delegates, special project coordinators, and regional representatives about the organization and activities of the Savoy Orders in their respective geographical areas. They also help coordinate support for the delegation and the Savoy Foundation's events and programs. In 2005, during the New York City visit of the Hereditary Prince, His Royal Highness Emmanuel Philibert of Savoy, with his wife, Her Royal Highness Princess Clotilde of Savoy, His Eminence Knight Grand Cross Edward Cardinal Egan, then Archbishop of New York, invited the royal couple to participate in a Sunday procession and solemn mass at the Cathedral of St. Patrick, together with members of the Savoy Orders. During the Mass, His Eminence welcomed the Royal Highnesses and the members of the Savoy Orders from the altar. On December 10, 2011, the representative of Prince Victor Emmanuel, Knight Grand Cross Dr. Sergio Pellecchi, and Knight Grand Cross Carl J. Morelli Esquire, the Prince's delegate, presided over the installation and promotion ceremony of the Knights and Dames in the Order of Merit of Savoy and the Order of Saints Maurice and Lazarus. Taking place at the main altar of the Cathedral of St. Patrick in New York City, the honors that were conferred that day recognized individuals in public service, medicine, the arts, music, government, business, and philanthropy. The following day, the Most Reverend Timothy M. Dolan, then Archbishop of New York, and now His Eminence Timothy Cardinal Dolan, was presented with the insignia of Knight Grand Cross of the Order of Saints Maurice and Lazarus, conferred by Prince Victor Emmanuel of Savoy. Having received the highest honor in the order, Cardinal Dolan was recognized by the Prince for his exemplary leadership as head of his large archdiocesan group and as an important church leader in America. While their traditions are deeply rooted in the past, the Savoy orders are actively engaged in meeting the challenges of the modern world. The charitable, educational, and humanitarian work of the American Delegation of Savoy Orders is accomplished through the American Foundation of Savoy Orders. Founded in 1993, it is a United States not-for-profit, tax-exempt charitable organization. It was formed primarily to aid hospitals, relief agencies, children's causes, and to support hospice care as well as cultural and educational programs. These charitable and humanitarian purposes are in keeping with the centuries-old hospitaller traditions of the Order of Saints Maurice and Lazarus, whose constituent order of St. Lazarus began as a hospitaller order ministering to lepers in the Holy Land during the Crusades. Members of the royal family actively support, attend, and lend their names through formal patronage of these worthy events and causes. To support its activities, every year the Savoy Foundation raises funds sponsoring the Savoy Ball, known as the Ballo di Savoia, and a spring reception called the Festa della Primavera. In particular, the Savoy Ball recreates the traditions and pageantry found in 19th century European court balls. Here are some highlights from the Savoy Ball in New York City on December 10, 2011. The event raised funds for the Foundation's Emergency Relief Fund and for the Latin Patriarchate's University of Madaba Scholarship Program to aid students in the Middle East. The 2011 gala also recognized Cindy and Mark Piggott, who generously funded the Savoy Order's Piggott Scholarship to provide financial aid to college students in the humanities and international studies. In 2005, the Savoy Foundation became a non-governmental organization in roster consultative status with the United Nations Economic and Social Council. This important role enables the foundation to participate in the medical, poverty relief, and educational work of the United Nations, and provides an excellent opportunity to form strategic alliances with the international philanthropic community with which the Savoy Orders are active. Additional Savoy Foundation events include the Savoy History Lecture Series. Inaugurated in 2003, these annual lectures focus on the history and culture of Italy and the Savoy dynasty. These delegation and foundation events continue the charitable traditions of the Savoy Orders under the patronage of the Royal House of Savoy. Their principles and benevolent works have continued for 1,000 years, through good times and bad. Triumph and adversity, tragedy and hope, always enduring under the leadership of the Royal House of Savoy. And with the coming of each new generation, the Savoy Orders remains dedicated to uphold their time-honored humanitarian principles of protecting the poor, the sick, and the weak by spreading the chivalric spirit into the distant and ever hopeful future. To learn more about the Royal House of Savoy and the Savoy Orders, visit the American Delegation and Savoy Foundation website, www.savoya.org.